Hi, if you're new here, my name's Kenna. I am 22 years old, and on April 15th, 2019, I was officially diagnosed with gastroparesis. But I suffered with the gastroparesis symptoms for about a year and a half prior. If you have never heard about gastroparesis, or don't quite know what it is, gastroparesis translates to a paralyzed stomach. So, the stomach doesn't empty food as quickly as it normally should, which leads to quite a few unpleasant symptoms like nausea, vomiting, lack of appetite, bloating, pain, early satiety, just to name a few. But there are more. There's no cure and very limited treatments. So those with this chronic illness have to completely change their lifestyle and learn how to live with this crippling condition. I think that is all I'm going to say about the specificities of this disorder, because today I wanted to paint a picture of what it is really like to suffer with this condition and what you don't read on the internet. I will, however, leave links to all of my previous videos on gastroparesis, as well as educational links down below if you want to learn more. Throughout my journey with gastroparesis, I often felt isolated, and like no one truly knew what I had to endure. If I'm going to be honest though, that is partly my fault, because I found myself sugarcoating my experience for others. We're told not to complain, to just suck it up and live with it. That we are adults and just have to learn how to go on in our lives and do all the typical adult things, even though my nausea is rated like 1000 out of 10, like vomit could be spewing at any time 24/7, and that I feel like I just swallowed a bowling ball and it's weighing me down so much that I can't even stand up straight. That I'm so malnourished, my hair is falling out in clumps, my nails are so brittle they break any time they grow past the tip of my finger, or that I can't even stand in the shower because my calves ache and burn after standing for only 30 seconds. Trust me, there's more. But just hearing that, how do you expect me and millions of others experiencing this to be okay and to suck it up and go to work or school or go through life when I often feel like I didn't even have a life worth living? One thing that always aggravated my boyfriend, and I guess rightfully so, was that I would never truly speak up about my suffering. Like I said, I sugarcoated it. I didn't think people would understand and would think I was just complaining because I don't look sick. I can't even imagine the pain my boyfriend had to endure watching the love of his life starve to death and waste away. And then whenever people asked me about it, I would just pretend like it's no big deal because I didn't want to bother anyone. Well, babe, this one is for you. I'm about to expose you, gastroparesis. I'm about to bother everyone and show everyone who you truly are. Before I move on, just keep in mind that this is one story. It's my story. Gastroparesis affects everyone so differently, so what I went through may not be what other people are going through, but I just wanted to share anyways, just to bring some attention to what people with gastroparesis do have to go through. And also, I will likely be showing pictures of my weight loss, so if that triggers you in any way, please consider not watching this video or watching with someone you can trust to help you get through this. And if I'm gonna be honest, I'm still a little bit nervous to film this because for some reason, I still feel like I should silence myself and not share how much I truly had to suffer, but it's not gonna happen this time. Gastroparesis, you will not silence me. Here we go. So what is gastroparesis? Gastroparesis is being nauseous all of the time. But not just the light nausea here and there, it's that intense nausea you get right before you're about to throw up all of the freaking time. It's like that annoying fly that you keep trying to kill, but for some reason it always lives on. Most of the time, nothing you do makes it better. I had a whole arsenal of supplies ready to combat the nausea. Those gross dissolvable Zofran tablets, ginger chews, ginger gum, ginger anything really. I used to eat so much ginger, it wasn't even spicy to me anymore. I had those little C-band wristbands as well. It was honestly my most worn accessory for 2 years. Even though I try to explain how bad the nausea is, I feel like I truly can't articulate how terrible it is to live with this day in and day out and for nothing to help it at all. And honestly, I could talk a bunch more about this crippling nausea and I probably will, but let's move on for now. Gastroparesis is also vomiting. Well, not for me specifically, thanks to emetophobia, which honestly just made living with the nausea even worse, because I also had to live with one of my fears about to happen to me all of the time. To put it into perspective, just think of one of your fears. Let's say it's heights. Well, what if you had to walk, or I guess, live 100 feet up in the air at all times, you think you would get used to it at some point, but you never do. Honestly, don't know if that was a good example, but just, I guess, think of one of your worst fears happening to you all the time, and then trying to live with that every single day. I don't know if that still makes sense, but just take my word on it, it was awful. But I just wanted to take some time to bring some attention to those gastroparesis sufferers who do vomit every day. They vomit so much their teeth fall out. They go through sick bags more than they go through toilet paper. They still push through work and school even though they frequently have to leave the room to vomit, because what else are they supposed to do when that is their daily reality? Gastroparesis is giving a fake smile and an awkward laugh when people ask if you're still sick or if you're getting better yet. No, I'm not. Gastroparesis is having to deal with people telling you they wish they had your disease so they could be skinny like you. I really, really hate this one. This condition is just so damn awful, and they have no idea what it's like to live with this every single day and for it to just not go away. It's also having people tell you that you eat like their dog or their baby, and in a negative way too. And yes, I've gotten both of those on multiple occasions. Speaking of baby, gastroparesis is also getting excited when you discover a new flavor of baby food. The plain banana with some chocolate chips thrown in there though will always be my favorite. The sweet potato warmed up with some pumpkin spice sprinkled on it is honestly a banger too. And I guess don't even get me started on those little applesauce pouches. So many fun flavors, but you do get sick of them after a while because that's all you eat. I'm pretty sure for a while my veins were just applesauce and liquefied fruit. Gastroparesis, oh, gastroparesis, takes away your social life and the desire to even have one. Do you realize how much food is a social thing? Anytime when you hang out with friends or family, there's almost always food involved. And for the longest time, I completely despised that others could just eat and not feel like their body was rejecting every last crumb that entered their body. I didn't want to be around people that could just eat like normal, and I convinced myself that others don't want to be around someone who can't eat when they can. I just spent most days, and I mean most days, locked up in my room, in my bed, throwing myself the biggest pity party. Honestly though, it was kind of justified. Really, the only time I left the house was when I'd go to school or work and try not to die. Gastroparesis is going to school and work and pretending like you're not internally suffering the whole time. It's spending half the lecture trying to meditate yourself from throwing up, or getting up in class and just sitting in the bathroom because you're almost positive it's gonna happen this time. It's having to squat in the middle of lab class or abruptly leaving the room in clinical because your vision gets blurry, your hearing goes away, and you start sweating, and you are seconds from passing out. But you don't tell anyone or just pretend like nothing happened because it's really no big deal and I'm fine. It's always having to have this giant pouch of medications and nausea remedies wherever you go, and always have an anxiety that you will never have enough Zofran or ginger chews to get you through the day. It's always having to scope out the bathrooms or an escape route wherever you go. It's collapsing the shower because you feel like your life isn't worth living anymore, because if you can't even have enough strength to stand in the shower or eat 500 calories a day, how in the hell am I supposed to be the best nurse, a wonderful mom, or a loving wife? Or how am I just supposed to enjoy life? It's constantly wondering, why me? And running through your past choices in your life, wondering where you went wrong to end up with a disease like this. It's laying in bed all day because you're so sick, and then hating yourself for being lazy and unproductive. It's always being so freaking tired. Sleep doesn't help it. Resting doesn't help it. Nothing helps this kind of fatigue. I was always so damn tired. So tired, I didn't even have the brain power to watch a cheesy love movie or a Disney show. That's how bad it was. It's falling asleep in lectures, on your laptop, or in your books while you're trying to study. Damn it, I was so, so tired. Gastroparesis is shaking and dry heaving on the bathroom floor after not eating for a week as your blood sugar is unknowingly plummeting and you're seconds away from going in a coma without even knowing it. It is being told you're severely malnourished and in starvation ketosis. It's spending a week in the hospital having to slowly refeed you. It's having to be awake while nurses shove a tube from your nose, down your throat, and all the way into your intestines. It's having to be on feeds for 24/7 and sleeping at a 30-degree angle on the most uncomfortable bedwedge. is having that giant nose hose pulled right back out of you. It is having to spend $100 on formula that's only going to last you a couple days. It is having the worst pain every time you swallow or pull on the tube. I thought I'd get used to it, but I never really did. It's having the sensation of feeling like you're choking with a tube. It's also having a pill get stuck behind your tube, the back of your throat, and watching your life flash before your eyes. Okay, maybe that one was a little bit dramatic, but in my defense, it was scary. Gastroparesis is going years without a diagnosis because you're told it's just acid reflux, it's anxiety, it's nothing because your blood tests are all normal, it's all in your head. It's you believing all of that and actually thinking that this is all in your head and that you don't need to try anymore. It's getting test after test until finally you get a gastric emptying scan. It's sitting alone in that radiology department for 4 hours studying for an exam the next day while you take the gastric emptying scan. It's getting anxiety during the test because you are convinced that this will just be another negative and that no one will ever figure out what's wrong with you. It's trying almost every single medication for this condition and them all stop working. It's having to get a medication from a Canadian pharmacy because they don't have it in the US. It is having to randomly start lactating because of your medication. Yes, this actually happened, and unfortunately, I do not have proof because I was just so embarrassed. It's having countless sleepless nights where you're literally up all night crying and shaking because the nausea is so bad you can't sleep. It is taking every laxative known to man, and most of the time, they don't work or barely work. And then one freaking time, they work too well. You wake up in the middle of the night sitting in your own poop, completely distraught, but luckily you have the most wonderful boyfriend who gets up with you at 2 a.m. to clean up the mess with you while you cry in the shower cleaning yourself up. I swore no one else in my life would ever know about that, but here we are. And all I have to show for this is me trying to be a good sport and washing the sheets the next morning and making the bed and then proceeding to take some embarrassing pictures to send to your boyfriend, trying to make light of the whole situation. Thank goodness this only happened once, but I know there are many people with gastroparesis who have to deal with this frequently. Gastroparesis is spending way too much money on herbs, teas, acupuncture, and other stuff because you're so desperate for relief. Some work and some don't, just like Western medicine, but it is a lot of trial and error. Gastroparesis is having doctors not believe you, getting you drug tested because you think drugs are causing this. It's crying at doctor's appointments, and I mean crying, straight up meltdown, because I'm slowly dying and they won't take me seriously. It's driving a 4-hour round trip twice just to swallow a pill and return the tracking device. It's going to 6 doctors until finally you find one that knows his stuff. But he's all the way in Ohio and you are in Florida, so you have to take your final exam and head to the airport within the same hour so you can go get the help you so desperately needed. Thank goodness for this doctor though, because he saved my life and got me the surgery that drastically changed the quality of my life. I still have quite a bit of GI issues, but nowhere near as bad, and I'm so grateful for that. Gastroparesis is spending every birthday and holiday sick and wishing you could just be normal for once so you can enjoy the days of the year that are supposed to be special, but instead, you are just in bed wondering what you were working so hard for. Gastroparesis is being sad. So freaking sad. Angry, worthless, hopeless, realizing that you wouldn't be mad if a car T-boned you or your car skid off the road. It's wondering how to still push through all of this pain, and for what, just to be sick another damn day? I always bottled up all of these emotions. I never talked about them to my boyfriend. I still don't know if I conveyed how sad I truly was to him, but babe, as you're watching this, I'm sorry I didn't tell you. I knew you were already so worried about me and didn't want to bother you. But for those of you watching, and for me in the future, please open up. Please talk to someone about your mental health. There is no shame in asking for help. Oftentimes, those with chronic illnesses have things so focused on their physical ailments that we completely neglect the mind. And damn, when your physical body is this sick this often, so is your mind. Gastroparesis is constantly feeling like you're a burden to your loved ones because they practically have to do everything for you and you can't help with anything. My boyfriend worked his butt off in his own business to get us a lovely home, any groceries and health supplies I needed. He took care of a lot of things around the house and still found time to take care of me, so I could focus on school, only work once a week, and rest as much as possible. I still can't believe I got lucky enough to have him in my life. He upheld his in sickness and in health vows before we even took them. could not have gone through this without him, and that is a fact. Gastroparesis is endless tears. So many tears. Tears of sadness, hopelessness, pain, jealousy, just so many tears. It is endless tests, x-rays, and blood work, probably enough radiation to be radioactive yourself, and enough blood work that you are just a human pincushion at this point. It's going to a wedding and only eating the mashed potatoes and a protein bar you have brought from home. Oh my goodness, it is the severe and painful bloating. Bloating that doesn't go away, not with gas X, heating pads, tea, baths, charcoal, and every natural bloating remedy there is. Depending on the day, I can literally look between 3 to 6 months pregnant. It seriously hurts so bad, and it's just so uncomfortable, and nothing helps it. No, Miralax does not work. Gastroparesis is losing way too much weight, where you wrap your hand around your forearm and you just feel bone. It is your spine sticking out, so whenever you sit on chairs or try to do a sit-up, it hurts. It's standing up from sitting down and getting so dizzy. It's getting so many unexplained bruises. It is just watching your body completely waste away, realizing there's not much you can do to help it. It is trying to stay strong and healthy though, and go on walks, but even that is too much sometimes. I feel like there's still so much more I could talk about and expose about gastroparesis, but this is all I have for now. And I feel like this doesn't even do mine and others suffering with gastroparesis justice, but I hope this helped you gain a little bit better of understanding. To end on a lighter note though, here's what gastroparesis did not take from me. I made it through nursing school and graduated with 4.0. My relationship with my boyfriend only grew stronger. I am now a cat mom to 3 of the most precious cats in the world. Seriously, I love them so much and they have given me so much comfort while I'm sick. And they are the cutest cats, you cannot argue that. My boyfriend and I still managed to make the best out of certain situations. We decked out our house for Christmas last year. I mean, decked out. Inside and outside, we completely went off, and just seeing that every day made me so happy. My boyfriend did the Not Your Hands Feeding Tube Challenge with me, and I was honestly really impressed, and it was such a fun way to make good out of a bad situation. I got a life-changing surgery. FUGP, you are much weaker now. Come at me, I dare you. I started this YouTube channel and have found so much joy in this, and I never thought I was talented enough to do this. I have so much more zest for life. I became more confident, bold, and secure in myself. I found my voice and will continue to use it. While gastroparesis completely broke me, I put myself back together in a better version of myself. I don't know what my future holds with gastroparesis, but I will not let it break me. I hope this video helped you understand a little bit more about what it is actually like to suffer with gastroparesis. Remember, this is just my story and my experience. There are people out there who go through so much more than me because they have more severe symptoms or other illnesses that make it worse. However, each and every one of you has pain in your life, and it is all valid. Life is just hard, especially with a chronic illness. Just know that I'm here for you and that you are not alone, and to get help if you need it. Remember, there is no shame in asking for help. Thank you so much for watching. It means the absolute world to me. I love you all, and remember to spread kindness and joy to those around you. I hope to see you again soon. Bye.